Where do you come off coming into court and suing? Do you think that someone's going to pay $187 a month for insurance and not make a claim?
Welcome to MsMojo, and today we're counting down our picks for the verdicts that left People's Court viewers and litigants stunned and confused.
Never mind, I changed
that's
my mind.
Yeah, please.
Actually, because...
That's exactly the way it happened.
That's exactly the way it happened.
Number 10, you owe him.
You owe him $5,000.
Plaintiff Jessica Ulmer sues her ex Shane Morrison after she stored her property at his rental. Despite him never charging her storage, she sues him because the place was sold and she didn't come get her things in time. Clearly it's her fault the items were disposed of.
You kept storing her stuff after this happened?
Believe that?
You're an idiot.
I know.
While it's no surprise she loses that case, the countersuit is a whole other matter. Ulmer's assault allegation against Morrison lands her in hot water with the judge. While allegations like this should be taken seriously, video evidence shows a very different situation than the plaintiff's version of events. Not only does the judge dismiss her claim, she rules in favor of the defendant. If anyone is owed money, it's him.
Your actions of going to the police ended up costing him a night in jail and a $5,000 retainer with her, where he had to put in sweat equity, good deal by the way, and got a new kitchen for the $5,000 in labor.
Number 9, prom dress fiasco. A custom-made prom dress didn't satisfy co-plaintiffs Malexa Mayweather and Dee Lewis, and it's not difficult to see why.
You look like a bird. It's horrible.
I know,
it looks horrible.
But when they posted the dress on social media and it got picked up by major media outlets, the defendant was inundated with hate from all corners of the internet. While under normal circumstances this would be the price of doing business, the plaintiffs and defendant agree the work on the dress was not finished. The plaintiffs posted the dress on social media without clarifying that it was an unfinished product. Because of that, defendant Kia Wagner's suit for defamation seems justified. However, Judge Million rules against her.
I am ordering the return of the $100 that you paid as a deposit, which had you received it, you would have just gone your merry way. And of course, your court costs on your counterclaim against them, zero.
While the evidence might not be there, the judge seemed almost shockingly unsympathetic to Wagner's perspective.
By the way, you look fabulous.
Thank you.
Number 8, ruling against a sugar daddy. The plaintiff in this case sued the younger woman he was showering with gifts and money after she wouldn't sleep with him.
How old are you?
I'm 59.
And how old are you?
27.
Oh.
Although she was shameless in using him, the defendant, Stephanie, never made any promises to pay him back in writing. The plaintiff was in denial about what the relationship really was and didn't understand why Judge Million ruled against him. However, viewers were shocked by the way she didn't punish the defendant at all.
You gambled and you didn't win the gamble.
That's not what happened.
That's exactly what happened.
Despite finding her behavior immoral, the judge and Stephanie both know she was savvy enough not to be on the hook legally.
You reap what you sow. Verdict for the defendant.
Number 7, he just kicked my door in. Plaintiff Devin Johnson wanted a full refund on a plumbing job that was ultimately unnecessary, even for the work that actually was done.
Do you have a picture of the car side of your car dented?
No, because we pulled it out with a plunger. We did, I swear to God.
Defendant Joseph Moretti alleges that Johnson kicked his car in a fit of rage when he didn't pay him back. At first, Judge Million actually felt Devin Johnson deserved some money back. He just didn't deserve the full $1,500 he was suing for.
Did you kick his car?
Nope.
You say he kicked the car, huh?
Yes. Got more cards.
That's going to cost you.
When he found out he wasn't going to get the full amount, he stormed out and violently kicked the gate door. Judge Million instantly reversed her decision and threw him out.
I'm ordering you to return $200
to him. I was doing that till he kicked my car. He kicked my car, too. Who's going to pay for the
car? Oh, you know what? He just kicked my door.
Number 6, group hug. Normally, People's Court litigants scorch the earth on the way out of the courtroom. These two neighbors end their case with a hug.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I never get... Wait, hold on one second. I want in.
Two women end up in court over car damage done by a tree trimming job. While the guy who did the trimming doesn't come off too well, it does turn out that the defendant is legally responsible.
You've got to sue him.
I know.
Please do it. Okay?
If I can come back to you, I will. No.
Instead of pushing back, she is legitimately sorry, and the two hug it out after the case is over. It's a rare moment of kindness and actual resolution in the court, and even Judge Million has to get involved.
I want to end on this because you guys are so nice.
Number five. Well, well, well. If it isn't the consequences of my own actions. Plaintiff Rebecca Elovich loved her expensive Kate Spade purse, stuffed with a myriad of expensive items so much that she left it on the pavement of a warehouse driveway.
Why was your purse on the ground?
Because I...
No, why? Instead of somewhere other than the ground. You have $3,900 in that purse.
For anyone with half a brain and a modicum of common sense, her loss was not a surprise. The audience even clapped when the judge ruled against her. But Elovich was genuinely stunned to be held accountable for her own carelessness. Apparently, it was everyone else's job to watch out for a purse left on the ground. She's so shocked, she can barely speak in the post-case interview.
It was later than you decided to go ahead and sue him for the whole amount, right?
Yes, which didn't work out.
Well, didn't work out, no.
No.
So sorry. All right.
Number four, rent reversal. Judge Million told the plaintiff straight off the bat that he wasn't going to get money back on rent paid to live in his illegal apartment because he had the benefit of living there.
You know the rent, even if it's illegal,
yeah,
the law doesn't allow it. Since you lived it out, you
don't.
Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and cross that part out
Yes. And
then ask you, why won't you give him his security deposit back?
But the slippery landlord he was suing just rubbed the judge the wrong way. The defendant completely denied knowing her former tenant. And she even alleges his footage of the apartment was not her property at all.
Because you look like a slumlord right now. Like a vicious, illegal slumlord. Because you're not only renting this place out, but you're renting it out in that condition. So talk to me, defend yourself.
However, the state of the apartment is so offensive to Judge Million that she reverses her own decision to strike out the plaintiff's rent. Instead, she orders a return of 1 month's rent plus the security deposit and tells the landlord exactly where she can go.
You are despicable. And you know what? Not only are you going to get your security deposit back, I know you gave up. You told me it's right, fine. The rent that I paid, no, you shouldn't have to live like that. So I'm going to order her to pay you back 1 month's rent for having to live like that.
Number three, overreact much? Plaintiff Yulitha Flowers is on a mission when she comes to the People's Court. She insists her landlord and housemate coming into her room and leaving a receipt for her is a massive violation of privacy and grounds to leave her lease. But the judge asserts this is not the grave offense she wants her to believe it is.
You do not get that because you're not winning. I find that you did not have a right to not only not stay, but also get all your rent back for the last 2 months.
Nor is it the real reason she left the lease. When Million rules against her, Flowers begins to sound more like she's doing an exposé than arguing her case. She can't believe what the judge is telling her.
He is allowed to win a case.
No, you know what he's allowed to do? He's allowed to put a receipt on your desk and ask you to leave the lights off. That's what your housemate is allowed to do.
The judge can't believe she isn't getting it.
If you don't get it, you are never going to get it. So there is no point in a continued explanation. Good luck, everybody.
Number two, no warranty, no problem. There's a reason Defendant Reynoso didn't use his full name. In this dispute over a car warranty, Judge Million allowed him to secure the necessary evidence during a recess. Why? Because she had an ace up her sleeve. She called the warranty company directly and found out that Reynoso's new evidence is clearly a lie.
You have it. But you didn't think the judge would want to see it when that's what you're getting sued for?
There is no warranty for the plaintiff's car. He or someone at his company just pocketed the money. The look on Reynoso's face as he realizes she knows everything is a level of shock that's rarely seen on the People's Court.
So who at your dealership thinks that I am an idiot?
His eyes glaze over when she not only rules against him, but slaps him with punitive damages for his dishonesty.
So I am also assessing an extra $1,000 in punitive damages.
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications.
Number 1. 20 years without a license. Sharon Stevens is a delight and as kooky as People's Court litigants come.
Okay. I was on the People's Court. Hi, y'all.
Exactly what happened is hard to grasp in her retelling, but basically, she was involved in a car accident and used the plaintiff's insurance. As a result, the plaintiff's insurance has skyrocketed. Stevens insists she is the primary driver of the vehicle. She had every right to use the insurance, but she really takes the cake when she insists she's a great driver.
I would never get out the car without looking right there and right there and right there. You understand what I'm saying? So
not
this
really.
May...
Despite driving without a license for about 20 years, she even sounds somewhat proud when she admits it.
I drove for about 20 years without a driver's license.
Did you get... She said that so proudly.
Despite the circumstances and Stevens' blatant confession, she wins the case. Not that she realizes it at first.
Verdict for the defendant.
Which of these verdicts surprised you the most? Tell us in the comments.
Because I get it. We're done.
Okay.
We're done.
But
do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from MsMojo and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.